Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to create the Party Next Door style, and we're going to delve into dark trap, or kind of in that Travis Scott kind of a lane where he created that dark side of trap, like horror trap. So we're going to mix the two kind of R&B styles mixed with that dark style to create a very mysterious dark R&B. So the first thing we need to go over is sound selection. So let's go to our browser. Close up, collapse. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Now, some people ask, where do you get this folder? This is just a folder with all our products in it. It's not for sale, this folder, but you can go to BusyWorksBeats.com/products if you want to find the various products we're using. For example, 808 Science drums. Let's pick out an 808, which is nice and long, but we can manipulate it later. And for this song, we want a long sub, like 808 acid, so let's open that up. Typically, a go-to 808 would be 808 carbon. It's just nice and pure. But for this song, we want a long, drawn-out 808 that we can manipulate later. So let's pick out a hi-hat, which we're going to change later. So let's go to X drums, hi-hats, open up closed hi-hat X. Now we need a kick drum, so let's go to the X drum kit again. Let's go to kicks. I found kick PC is good for R&B. And hip hop. It's kind of like the blend between the two. And let's go to the snare clap. So let's go to snares. We need to find something that's layered with the clap, which is snare CF. And let's see what else we need. We need a piano. So let's pull up Nexus. Let's close out the browser. Let's open up Nexus. Now I was mapping out the scale of possible notes, and I'll show you how to do that in a second. Let's open up Nexus. And we're going to go to piano, and let's drop down to the grand piano. Always a great instrument to start with, a grand piano, because it's just straightforward, and it's just a great tone. It's not it doesn't change. It's not like a pad where the pad could have a lot of resonance and change the tune, change the pitch a bit, or detune the pad. So just if you ever get lost, try grand piano or guitar sounds to help you with chords. Now here's the secret here. We're going to go to system. We're going to change our master tuning and pull that down to 432. Some say 432 hertz is the divine kind of language, or how life works. I forget, life resonates with 432 hertz. Now that's because frequency is built off of strings. And when you divide a string, that's what creates the different frequencies and different octaves. And they found, there were tests done, where 432, if you divide all the strings, it divides evenly, whereas our system now at 440 hertz, you divide the strings and it's not an even number. So I forget which video it was, but they did like mathematic equations going over that concept. So we're going to change that tuning to 432, and let's clone that. So we have a secondary piano. Now this piano we're going to use as a backdrop chord piano. So let me mark these as chord piano. And one's going to be the melody piano. Whoops, can't spell piano, but that means piano. So let's build out the scale, and then I'm gonna move this MIDI into the piano. So here I was using 3X OSC. Actually, let's copy this over. Let's hit Control X, hit Control V to paste that MIDI, and let's delete 3X OSC. Let's go into the piano roll and let's start building out the scale. Now I only have 5 notes of the scale. So I know these notes are going to be used in songwriting, but we have to fill in the gaps to build out a full scale. Typically, scales consist of each letter of the alphabet. So A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So you're going to have some version of that in your scale if you're dealing with regular scales. Now, we're talking about diatonic scales, not chromatic scales. Anyway, scales are preference, okay? So if you ever get caught up in all this music theory and all this, people telling you have to do this, have to do that, just realize how many scales are around the world. Not everybody goes by Western scale references. It's just a sequence of notes which we want to hear in that order. That's what a scale is, period. So let's start here at E. So let's start filling in the gaps. Our ear kind of will guide us through. I mean, your ear is telling you you want to hear A. Dun. I can't sing. Dun. And then you start back up at F sharp. So we've done a full octave here. We've gone from E to E. So all we have to do, make sure your top and bottom notes are the exact same. Hit shift, left click and drag. and there you can have multiple octaves. Just make sure you're starting and stopping on the note you started with. Let's pull the volume down. So now we know, and this doesn't mean the scale is in the key of E. It just so happens that we started there. So the question is, what do we do with a scale? Well, with scales, you can create melodies, chords. There's a lot of things you could do with a scale. For this piano, this is the melody piano. We're going to get into that later, but let's copy scale reference into pattern 2. For the chord piano, let's hit Control V. So once we have our references, let's start accounting for the sounds. Let's double-click everything in the channel rack. You want to go to your mixer, right-click, insert 1, go to channel routing, route selected channel starting from this track. Now everything is accounted for in the mixer. And let's go to pattern 2. Let's go to our playlist now. Let's right-click and select pattern 2. Let's insert that into the playlist. Let's go back to the channel rack and go inside the piano roll. Now what we're going to do here is build out chords. So you want to start on a note which you want to hear, because I'll show you different systems as to how you can build chords from scales. Now there are many different systems on how to build chords, and we go over all that stuff at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Learn a lot more. So let's pick a note we want to hear. So let's say you want to hear the note D. So the question is D the top or bottom note of some chord? Let's assume it's the bottom note or the root note of some chord. So let's skip every other note within the scale to build out a chord. So we're going to go D, F sharp, A, and C. Now different scales have different chords associated with each note in the scale. So it's not always going to sound like the greatest chord ever. But this is a system you can use to build chords right away. See, that sounds bluesy. So we can either change the chord or change the way this chord is presented. So let's get rid of the top note. So these chords are not going to be to the forefront. So right now they sound very loud and in your face, but later on we're going to actually push them to the back with some filtering. So let's pick another chord. Now I'm going to stretch this chord out so it has a little longevity, and let's pick another tone. And let's go to F sharp. And at F sharp, we're going to do the same thing, going upwards, skipping every note within the scale. So we have F sharp, A, C. Now getting these sound bluesy, so it's going to go duh. So let's, instead of using that C, let's hit Control down to invert the C down an octave. Now what we can do is actually change the tone. So here's a secret technique. Once you kind of have your scale mapped out, you can actually move the key of your song by hitting Control A, Shift up and Shift down to test out different tones. That tone is just bluesy to me. But these chords, it doesn't matter which scale we go to or key, they're always going to sound bluesy, because the chord sequence is what holds the emotion, not the chord itself. So it doesn't matter which key you play, they're still going to give us the same emotion. So I'm going to flip this note, Control down. Try a different chord. This just sounds so bluesy to me. So let's move from F. Let's go back to E just to keep it the same. So I was just showing you how you can change the key, but still with maintaining the emotion of the chords. Let's go to A, A, C, and then we're going to skip D, go to A minor. That fits the mood a little bit better versus picking that other chord. So in chord progressions, when you go down, generally you're pulling the energy down, the emotion downward, so you feel sad. As before, we went up, it was kind of a happier type of sound. So those are the chords we're going to use. Now we can choose to use it in a deep octave or a higher octave. So I'm hitting Control A, Control up, and I think that's just a little too bright, so let's pull it back down. Now with the chord piano, we're going to actually muffle the sound. So let's turn on the master filter. It's on low pass filter at 24 dB per octave. And we're going to lower the cutoff frequency to muffle the sound. So it's kind of like putting a hand in front of your face. You know, you really can't hear me unless I release the hand. So we're pushing it to the background. So that's the secret for the style. Now what we're going to do is turn up the resonance so it hollows out the sound. What resonance is pretty much an EQ boost at the cutoff frequency point. Pretty much how you can interpret it. And it makes things sound hollow. Now what we're going to do is enhance the sound by adding reverb. Now the thing with processing your sound inside the plugin is that this stuff happens before you get into your mixer insert. So if you want more control over your mixing, I would actually suggest you take off any effects on the sound inside of the plugin and actually start doing your mixing inside your mixer. So I took off the ensemble, and now we're, you know, dealing with the raw piano sound. So here we're going to open up an EQ to see what's going on. So we're in the low mids. I'm going to get a little more advanced here, but this is for people who are trying to learn new mixing techniques. Let's open up a passive EQ, which allows us to deal with the mid and side, or the mono and stereo. I like to use this on pianos because it makes them seem bigger than they are. So what we're going to do is use a high pass filter for the stereo. So we're going to cut out any low bass frequencies in our fully left and fully right ear, so it doesn't kind of clog up the left and right ear perception, so we feel the bass in the mono. And add a low pass filter to the mono so that we really can't hear the high frequencies in the center, but we hear them on the side. So it feels like our piano kind of gained width just by filtering each of those. Now we're going to make it feel even bigger by EQing. This is an EQ boost, not a cut. It's on boost mode. We're going to boost. It doesn't matter how many dB. We're just going to turn this up until it feels right at the frequency right above the high pass filter. So we're going to boost about 330 hertz. We're going to focus on those low mids. So now the piano feels very wide because we're changing the perception based on the EQ. So that's one way to make your piano bigger. Now for the center, I want to boost up just below the low pass filter. So we're doing the opposite here. So we're going to boost up at 4K, 5K, which is right below the low pass. Now there isn't much frequency activity up there because we're playing a low octave anyway. So now let's go to a compressor, which let's use, where is it at? The V, I think it's the 160. It's not the right compressor, but there's a DB, I can't remember the name of it, by Native Instruments, the DBX 160, unless I'm confusing it with this version. I might be. I thought there was a, let me see if there's a Native Instruments version of that DBX 160. Oh, duh, the 160. So I was right. Okay, so it just looks different. So anyway, this compressor kind of has a, it lets the transient through, but it squashes the rest of the sound. So we get a nice transient peak, but it kind of pushes the sound down. This is what they use for pop piano. So when you see it above, when you see this thing turn above, that means we're compressing. That gives us that poppy piano kind of sound. Now let's change the compression. I believe this is the ratio. Let's turn that up a bit. And you can hear it pulling up on the volume. Now the only thing is the release time. I wish I can control, but you can't. So let's pull down the threshold a bit. Let's crank it down to 4:1. You can also turn the output up if the signal gets quieter. So what I've done is created a little more transient activity. Now that subtlety will add up when we get into the full sound. Whoops. Let's load up a reverb. Let's go to Fruity Reverb 2. And let's create a nice space for the piano. So you can see how much work goes into one sound. Okay. Let's add a little wetness, a little width. Turn up the decay time. Turn down the bass in your reverb for this sound. Because we don't want the sound to get muddy. That's defeats the purpose of all our EQing. This creates a nice kind of tail to the piano. So now what we're going to do is push it to the back. So we did all that work to push it to the back, but now it has a characteristic which will help it stand out. Okay, so beyond that, let's move into the melody piano. So let's change the BPM down to 108 for this sound. Now this is a common dance BPM, but we're going to produce in double time, which means the song is actually going to be perceived at half the tempo, but we're using double the tempo. Okay, so let's go to a blank pattern, like pattern one. Let's pull up our scale reference and let's start building out a melody. Now there are a lot of aspects to melody. But what we're going to do is kind of go after that, started from the bottom sound. So it goes one, two, do, 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 do. Okay, so we're going to copy that, but not the exact same notes. But I'm going to show you how to get that sampled sound without even needing a sample. So first you need to pick out a tone which matches your chords. So let's start on E, since our, I believe our chord has something to do with E. Actually, we started at D. So the BPM is a little bit slower. Now this note is not in the scale. Sometimes you're going to use notes outside of the scale to add what's called tension, and this is what creates contrast in your music. So right now it sounds like a regular piano. So I'm going to show you how to, without even opening up Edison and resampling and doing all the extra work, what you can do is actually modulate the volume. Okay, so let's go to the channel volume, not the fader volume, because the fader volume, if you lock it in, every time you want to make a fader change, it's going to reset the fader. So it's best to work with channel volume in this case. Let's right click, create automation clip. Now you don't have to do this infinitely. All you really have to do is do it once. Change your snap to grid to maybe 1/4 beat, something very microscopic. And we're going to right click and copy that first point. We're going to right click three other points. Let's paste that value. So now the volume dips down right at the end. So it kind of creates a stop-go effect. And you can copy and paste this all the way throughout. So let's chop it into half beats. Delete that. Now for this automation, since you sliced it evenly, now you have to make sure you sliced it on the beat. Now you can just hit Control-B. But you have to make sure you sliced it on the beat or else it's going to be off time. So now it sounds like a stop and go piano, just based on the channel volume. Now what you want to do to make it trippy is give it a lot of reverb. So the reverb is like stopping and going, and that's the trippy part. And let's turn up the mod wheel here for the reverb, which makes the pitch bend for the reverb. And that creates kind of like that washed sound. Now I've exaggerated the reverb, but I want to, you know, you don't want to copy everything about a song. You want to make it your own. And that's what this whole, you know, that's what BusyWorksBeats.com is all about. We're showing you how to create your own voice, but in the mind of the artist, so that you're not always copying somebody else's song. Right now we're creating our own sound for Party Next Door. So we're using all the same technologies. Now we have that really trippy piano. We can even add delay to make it even trippier. I would do ping pong at a fast speed, like 1/32nd. And that creates a little more rhythm and bounce. So let's add our drums. So notice we started with the music first. Make sure we are getting all the elements. So we have the piano, we changed the tuning. Now let's get into the drums. So we're gonna do the 808 last because that we need to deal with the pitch later. Let's deal with the kick and the hi-hat. So the hi-hat needs to be a little special. We need to do something to it. And what we're going to do is open the hi-hat. Firstly, we're going to change the pitch so it sounds like a lower frequency from the default when I'm hitting middle C. Typically, you would play a lower key, but what I'm going to do is just change the starting key. So we're going to go to our envelope and right-click to change the starting key. So I'm pressing middle C, but it's really playing the note G in this case. And that way we can play a lower key just using middle C instead of playing on our keyboard lower or higher. So that's one way. Now we need to add a filter. Here's the secret here, is a low pass filter. You don't want to muffle it too much. So get it right at the tip where it starts to get muffled, but it's not fully muffled. Then you want to crank up your resonance and figure out the frequency. Okay, and that's how you create those trippy kind of modern hi-hats. Now we're going to process it a little bit more. Firstly, we're going to turn the out knob up a bit to cut down on the tail of the sound and make it a little more sharp. And we're going to create a quick delay. So I'm trying to think, should we do it the manual way or the easy way? Let's do it the hard way. So let's go to Fruity Delay Bank. This isn't really hard, but I just like to say it's hard. Let's pan one left. So we have a delay on the left side. And we're going to change it from tempo time. So take that T off and pull it down in milliseconds to about 46 or lower. So it has that kind of spring reverb sound. Now also, you want to turn down the feedback meter a bit so it doesn't have a long drawn out tail. You just want a quick hit. So about 50% is good. Now we're going to turn on delay bank 2. Pan this one right, turn off the tempo, pull down the milliseconds to about just a little bit higher than the one before, so about 50, and the first one's about 30. So now the hi-hat kind of bounces around quickly, and we perceive it as being a reverb of some sort. You could also do this with reverb, but that's a cooler way. So let's add this in. So for the hi-hat, we're going to do triplets for the most part and then do hi-hat rolls. So it's going to go. So for triplets, you have to go into your piano roll. So right click, go to piano roll, change your snap to grid to 1/3 beat. And we're going to add triplet notes in here. And you can see the snap to grid menu kind of changed to this 3 notes per beat kind of view. Whoops. And now we can add triplets. So let's add the triplet notes in. Now, if it gets a little too messy with triplets, we can always just use triplets as a change up. So I wanted to go t-t-t-t-t-t-t-t. So the hi-hat roll is going to go right here, but we need to change our timing back to a quarter measure. So let's go to snap to grid half step. I found this is the easiest one for me. And let's stretch this note out to occupy the full beat. Let's grab that slice tool, and you want to right click and delete any excess that's overlapping into the next beat. And since it's locked in and controlled, you just want to hit Control U to auto slice it based on your snap to grid. So it's going to chop it into half steps. So let's make sure we're right clicking and cutting the sample by itself. It needs to be a little sharper for me. So let's pull the out meter up a little bit more. Needs to be a little bit faster actually. So let's select these and let's go to a quarter step to make it sharper. Hit Control U. Now we can turn down the hi-hats. They don't need to be that aggressively loud in the mix. Let's control our kick and our snare. So the kick's gonna go boom, cha, boom, cha, boom, boom. So those hi-hats are gonna, you know, rev us up for that snare. So we need to focus on the snare timing. It may need to be delayed just a little bit. Boom, cha, boom. It's a little too early. So let's go to our snare, go to the wrench tool, turn up the shift a bit. So now let's layer the snare. It's just, we can process it later, but let's just layer it with harder elements. Snare, TR is a little bit harder. Now I'm not going to make this super loud like some people would and overtake the sound. I'm going to use this as a layer. So let's turn this down in the mix. Turn it up. So now you really can't tell it's there. Add that 808 to create that nice contrast and create the darkness. So here we have that long subby 808 I was talking about. First we need to make sure it's tuned, so right click, go to edit. It's going to pull up Edison, and in Edison we are going to tune find the pitch of the 808. Now there are more precise technologies involved. We have a video called How to Tune Instruments in Any DAW. You want to go watch that video for a more precise way of tuning your samples in FL Studio. Well, actually you don't even need FL Studio. In any DAW. So let's go to the pitch tool. Let's go to detect pitch regions. And this 808 is primarily in the key of F sharp. So let's go to our envelope. Left click and reset the root note. And then right click on F sharp. If you mess up, you can go to reset. Some people left click, that does something completely different to where you can only play that note. So I can't play any other notes except that note. That's what that does. It locks you into one note only. But if I right click, it's retuning the sample. So now we have the 808. We're going to play it in low octaves in the song, but you want to play it in a higher octave so that you understand the tone, because I see too many times producers have their 808 bass way out of tune with the rest of the song, and it just throws off the whole song. So let's start in a higher octave. And I typically would use the scale, but I can go by ear at this point. But remember, here's a key fact, or key element. I don't know if it's key fact. But the 808 is tuned to 440 hertz middle A. So we actually need to pull it down a couple cents so that it matches the 432 hertz middle A that we tuned in Nexus. Okay, so that's why the 808 sounds off, even though I'm playing the right key. So we need to pull down one of these notes. So I'm going to play the note. Let me figure out where the melody started. Now you can do this with the guitar rig, or you can do this by referring to your melody. So the first key is D, so I'm going to play D on my keyboard in a high octave. So right now it sounds off. It sounds too high pitched. Okay, and here's another mistake that producers don't continuously tune. So now we need to pull it down to 432 hertz. I'm going to keep playing D on the keyboard and slowly pull down this pitch knob here. Now, keep in mind, I turned the pitch range to only one semitone, so I'm not changing the key, and that's important. Okay. So now it's more in tune. I pulled it down about 30 cents, and now we're matching 432 hertz middle A versus 440 hertz middle A tuning. So let's go inside our piano roll in pattern 5. Let's go to right click, piano roll. And let's build out our 808 line. Now again, I like to start in high octave so I can hear the tone. Now our goal here is to make it dark, so we need to get away from this kind of upward motion and go downward. Change it up. Again, we're going to drop the octave in a second. Stretch out the pattern 5. Let's go to the second portion, second bar. Let's pull this up in octaves, hit control up. So octaves are very common in bass in general, especially for 808s. Let's hit control down twice. So we get that nice low octave, and it's almost inaudible. I have subwoofers on, and I can't really hear tone, I just know it's there. It's lower than the subwoofer, so that's how low we're going. It's a little rumble. Bubble up the 808 a bit. I like to say bubble up because it creates a bubbly tone. You could do this with different plugins, but the goal here is to saturate the tone. We can do this with many different things. I'm going to use, let's keep it FL Native since you're going to get these project files for free. Let us use Fruity Blood Overdrive. Now, the only thing that's not FL Native is the Nexus plugin. So let's turn up the preamp. Let's turn down the post gain. And also, you can replace those pianos with FL keys if you'd like. So that preamp is distorting the sound, but we're making sure that post gain is down so it's not overly loud. Let's solo the 808. You hear that rumble? Now, some might not like that because it's in such a low octave, but in this case, it's fine. Now, let's make the 808 a little more unique. I'm going to add fruity chorus. Now, you're like, why would you ever change the phase of the bass? Well, this is one of those genres where you can be experimentative with the sound. I'm also going to open up an imager from Isotope, and I'm going to spread out certain frequency ranges. So I'm going to pull in that bass mono so that it's controlled, and I'm going to widen the low mids and highs. Some people even like to add reverb to the bass. Let's try that out just to add width. Let's turn up the stereo separation knob, turn up the wet level, turn down the decay time, and get rid of any bass elements. Like, so we're going to low cut. Now I need my headphones to hear this because I really can't tell over the monitors. Let me turn up my headphones. So the bass is a little more, let's turn down the wet level for the reverb. A little more unique. You might want to try a flanger or a phaser. Let's try a phaser instead of a chorus effect. It just makes it different, you know. So with the 808, you have the option here to make it kind of the stop and go effect. So if you want that, go to your volume tab in your sampler and turn the hold parameter up, turn everything else down. So now the 808 will only play for the note length. So right here, I want the notes to be a little bit longer. Stretch this one out. I was getting a little too experimental with the bass. Let's take off the phaser. And the reverb, it just kind of, not that it's not a good sound, it's that it's kind of killing the sound as far as its volume. Let's turn up the post gain a bit. Now, if you want your 808 to sound more aggressive, you would put it, since we're in a softer genre, we're using more ands, like one and two and. If you want it aggressive, you're going to add it on the one, two, three, four, right on the beat. So let's create two different versions of the 808 to see how we can change up the mood if we wanted to. Let's right click. It's good. Let's get a pattern six. Let's insert this into the playlist. Let's create another bass line. Doing the same technique, right click, go to piano roll. We're going to create in a higher octave this time. So this one's going to be focused on the down or the beat. So it's going to go. Drag out so it's a nice contrast. So we have short and long. So now we have a more aggressive tone. Now I'm going to drop that down a couple octaves. Hit Control A, Control Down. You see it adds a little more aggression. So this is where Travis Scott would come in. The first half might be where P and D starts. So you have different variations in your bass. Piano kind of got washed out because we use so much mix level on the reverb. We kind of cut on the. Now what I'm going to do is go to the mixer, add that DBX 160 on the compressor to remember we did that for the transients. Let's do it again for the melody piano. So it has a nice plucky sound in the beginning. Still maintains that reverb. You see we're pushing the compressor very hard, but the point is to add that clicky sound. So we're using the compressor this time to reshape the sound. Now, technically, in the P&D style of the piano, there's a little rapid fall at the end, so it's not like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It kind of goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. So let's add some more notes. That effect is kind of pumping at the end, so when we go 1, 2, 3, 4, it's not working on those fast notes. So you can either shorten your automation so it catches every single note, or you can leave it as is. I don't think it's a problem. Now add a pre-delay to the reverb to make it more of an echo, so it doesn't work on the initial part of the sound. Now that second hit is a little too much. Experiment is the master pitch. Now what I'm going to do is pitch up the 808 so it's not so low, because this will affect the 808 sample. So I'm going to pull that up an octave. But for the master pitch, you want to pull it down and check different things like -400 cents. And that's how you get that chop and screw type of sound. But some things are a little out of tune. Let's pull it up. So let's turn off the 808, because that seems like the only thing that's out of tune at these lower frequencies. And I think that actually sounds really cool. So what we have to do here is just make sure the 808 is tuned properly. For some reason it sounds out of tune, even though we tuned it. So let's... down. So again, this is why when you work with really low octaves in your 808, it's hard to actually hear the tone, and it actually can sound out of tune even though it's not. So that's the weird part about low octave 808. So really, just if you do this thing, which I think is a cool sound, let me save it as a new version, you really have to retune your 808s, or some samples might be stretched a certain way so they don't match the pitch bend, but you'll figure it out. Let's arrange this like it would be a build-up instead of just straight-up bass, because bass usually doesn't come in for a while. Turn that hi-hat down as well. Get rid of the claps and snare. I was trying to... paste these automation clips. Sorry about that. So let's hit shift, left click, and drag over. Now the timing's off, so let's go to snap to grid, half beat, and let's fit these in. Not sure how I deleted those, but they got deleted somehow. Hit shift up, fit it in, and then we can play it back. Let's go back. Now the bass sounds off. I do like the second bass a little bit better than the first. The first was too, it fit into the groove too much. Second bass is not so in the groove. Now I'm going to retune the 808, so let's pull the pitch down manually. Now some of these notes. And when you pitch down again, be aware that the tuning, all the work we did kind of changes, so you got to be a little sloppy on the latter part. So I took Fruity Blood Overdrive off to here. It's a little smoother. Let's leave it like this. Turn it on arena style reverb just to add a little different texture. Let's pull it up an octave. Let's go transpose up one octave. I think that sounds better. It's just too low of an octave before. It sounds a little more weird R&B style. Again, at this point, you would sing over the beat or rap like Travis Scott or one of those two artists, Party Next Door, Drake. And you would make a song out of it, and that's what's going to take your production to the next level when you record that audio over the track and then produce over top of that. So that's how you take it to the next level, and I think a lot of producers are just missing that audio idea. To understand, you know, when you send off a beat to an artist, usually the producer gets the song back to do a little more work, but that's what... That's the step a lot of them missing. So I might record over this track as a demo. Depends on how much time I have. So hopefully if I have enough time, I'll record a demo kind of track over it. Not a lot of work, but just something like a rough draft. Then you get a better idea of how you would turn this, take the song to the next level. She wanna know the friends don't know. She don't want, she don't want more.
Cheese, broccoli, and cheddar cheese. I got dreams. trying to take a meal on real estate, trying to get my kids all the estates, trying to get my kids out of West States, in the West End, baby. Yeah, they know we gon' crazy. Travis Scott and me, Cat Top, and I'm rapping like I'm Jay-Z. And we good, look, look. I done came from the bottom, now where? Like an elevator, I stay. I'm real, good God. What they talking about, trash? I come through the block looking real hot.
So thanks for watching today. If you want these project files for free, you want to click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.